back out here, motherfucking Wake Up Morning Show, man. It's your boy, you Grady. Why are you Grady?
I don't sure girl know about Breezy. It's still looking like I don't wear bras, B.
Y'all know who I am. Filthy Dre, Big DM. We back. The Wake Up Morning Show is going down. We live Monday through Friday, 9, 11, 30 a.m.
Yeah, I bust down, Tatiana. Yeah, I wanna see you bust down.
Bust down, Tatiana.
Bust down, Tatiana.
I wanna see you bust down.
Over.
Pick it up, not break that shit down.
Break it down.
Speed it up, not slow that shit down on the gang.
Slow it down.
Bust it, bust down, bust down, bust it, bust it, bust down on the gang.
Over.
Bust down, Tatiana.
Bust down, Tatiana.
I wanna see you bust down. Pick it up, not break that shit down.
Break it down.
Speed it up, not slow that shit down on the gang.
Slow it down.
Bust it. Bust it down. Bust it. Bust it. Bust down on the gang.
What up, thoughts? Welcome to the show. We back.
Going down. Building, you know what I'm saying? It's going digging down.
Yes. I like the little breaking break we had there.
Right. DJ My Papaya in the mix for Shit Show. We got a special guest in the building, man. Tell the world who you are.
Don't know the face, don't know the name. DJ XO, we in there.
How you feeling, man?
Feeling good, man. Just working.
Working on everything.
Yes, sir.
So, let's just get into it. I just want to know, like, you going to have birthday drops every year? Like, what we going to get?
You said birthday drops?
Yeah. You always drop some on your birthday.
Oh, yeah. That's just my little thing I do. You know?
That's cool, though. It's pretty fucking lit.
So how you stay focused enough to actually get that done? I know a lot of people say, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, and then life happens, or, you know what I'm saying, shit happens and they don't make the deadline. So how you stay focused and make sure something drops on your birthday every year?
I mean, you got to, first of all, you got to just do what you say,
facts.
You know?
Yeah.
And then second of all, you got to have a good team, too, mm-hmm. You know, because if you don't got a good team, you can't get behind,
right.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Even with a good team, sometimes people still get behind.
Facts.
We didn't got behind before, so that's important, though.
Speaking of teams, I know you're part of a new team. Did you just get a record deal?
Yeah, I just signed a deal for sure.
Can you talk about that? Can you elaborate on what's going on with that?
Me and Jay Prince basically partnered together.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? And he basically stepped in and just kind of hit me out with the things I wasn't, you know, strong in, like, you know, getting in touch with certain people,
mm-hmm.
You know, getting them certain positions where, you know, we can really make moves.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, you know what I'm saying, my label, No Sleep, you know what I'm saying, we came together with Jay and, you know, we about to make history.
So in your label, are you going to have, like, strictly artists? Or are you going to have other producers? Like, what all do you plan on putting on there?
Well, I actually already signed my first artist. His name is C-Daddy. You know what I'm saying? Dope artist, but... You know, we do everything. We gonna have producers. I want actors.
All that.
Everything.
Everybody.
We want all the money. For real.
So what role do you play in the No Sleep team and No Sleep management? Are you like, what do you do?
I mean, I'm an artist, producer, DJ. I'm all that I always been. I'm just, you know, I just wear like a CEO hat too.
Yeah.
You know?
So what did you do first? Like, how did you get into doing like all that shit? Like, I gotta do it. Nobody else gonna do it for me?
Nah, this is something that we always just wanted to do.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Me and my homies, this is just, it's always been our mindset, you know, since we first got out of high school, you know, really got interested into to this side of the music part. We always wanted to be bosses. We always wanted to, you know, have people under us. I didn't think I was going to be an artist, you know what I'm saying? So we thought we was going to be doing more so this type of work.
Yeah.
It just so happened to work this way, too, you know.
So at what moment did you figure like, hey, okay, I gotta be an artist, or I'm going to be an artist?
Man, I think when that Off the Lot kind of started taking off, I think that's kind of what did it all the way. Like,
so that was one of your first songs?
That was probably one of my, that was like my third or fourth song that I ever like recorded.
That's crazy. Yeah.
That was a birthday drop too, wasn't it? Then you, that was the first time I think that we interviewed you when that song came out.
And that was like my first mixtape, my first...
Yeah.
Right.
That's, you know, crazy. Yeah.
And that tape wasn't even a full tape of like me on like songs like that.
Yeah.
I just had like a couple songs on it and everything else was like other people. I was doing like the DJ Khaled thing.
Yeah. And that song did real good, huh? Wasn't it number one for a long time?
Yeah, it did very well.
So how did you feel about that? Like, you know what I'm saying? It's my third song. I'm just trying this out and it's like... It's going good.
I don't know, bro. I just looked up, bro, and it was working.
Yeah.
And next thing you know, we just was we just started smashing. We was going, I think we was going on tour when it really started taking off.
Mm-hmm.
I was on tour at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't even see it all the way, like how crazy it was getting.
Yeah.
I just was really just seeing it over the internet and stuff like that. So when I got back home, it was like, it was just super hot. Yeah. It was just like the hottest song out.
Yeah,
so,
it was jumping. It definitely was doing something. Definitely, you know what I'm saying? So you was on tour, what you was doing on tour? Like you was...
I think at that moment I was DJing. Well, I think for Kirko, because I was DJing with Kirko Bangs at that time.
Uh-huh.
We was on a couple tours.
And I know you work with a lot of artists. You know, you DJ for a lot of artists and you produce for a lot of artists.
Mm-hmm.
So at that time when Off The Lot was coming out, did you already have like credits for notable artists or did that come after Off The Lot?
Nah, before Off The Lot, I had been already producing records for people and being, you know, being competing in that area.
Mm-hmm.
That was just my way of just all the way getting in and making just everybody respect me, you know.
So when you're on stage, is it easier for you to perform or is it easier for you to be a DJ?
I think it's the same now. In the beginning, it was probably easier to DJ, obviously, you know, because that artist side, it's kind of like a science to it.
Yeah.
You got to kind of figure it out, you know, how to be able to make the people move,
right,
how to move the right way,
mm-hmm,
you know, how to do certain things when the music dropped to just kind of help, you know, with the people or
right,
with the crowd.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So how do you have your relationships with rappers when you produce for them? Do you just send out shit and then have them pick what they like, or do you kind of sit down with them, do you have a conversation with them, or how does that work for you?
Well, like, as far as when I'm producing records?
When you're producing records, yeah.
Well, it varies. Like, I'd rather us be in the lab together.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But sometimes that don't happen. Sometimes you got to send them. So it just depends on, you know, what they like to do. But if it's my choice, then I'm going to get in the lab with them.
Yeah. But if it's like, do you pick and choose your artists? Like, okay, this is a big artist. Let me send them shit just in case. Or do you feel like the same way about all artists? It don't matter big or small.
No, I mean... I try to treat everybody kind of the same,
mm-hmm,
but I mean, it is a point where I kind of draw the line.
Definitely.
But most cases, you know, it's some artists that they don't have nothing going on, and I've never charged them to this day. Or it's some artists that,
yeah,
you know, it just depends.
Definitely, yeah. It's all about the relationship, huh?
Yeah.
Most definitely. So with this new album you got, mm-hmm, Young Legend 3, what's your favorite song on there?
Man. That's hard, bro. I like the new record I got called Big Bank. I really like that record.
Uh-huh.
I really like this record I got called What You Saying.
Yeah, I like that one too.
And I got this other record. I forgot the name of it, but...
How often does that happen?
A lot.
How often do that happen? Do you ever forget your words?
Yes, all the time.
So what do you do if you forget?
You just gotta play it off.
Oh my god.
You gotta just kinda act like you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I mean, I feel like that'd be easy for you because you do so much shit. Like, I feel like you forgetting your words is like common. Like, you probably just got through DJing and got a show.
When you a DJ, you learn how to improv, that type of stuff.
Yeah.
You know, like that. But
mm-hmm,
yeah, all the time. There's not one artist in this world that don't happen to.
That's funny.
I'm telling you.
That is funny.
That's funny. So it seems like when you be performing, like, you're like a rock star, you feel me? Like, I sat and watched you one day jumping across the stage at Warehouse, and like the little white kids, they were so lit. And it was like, as you was jumping this way, they was running that way, you go this way, they run that way too. Like, and it was like, have you ever just, when you're doing that shit, just watching them like, damn, like, I really got these people acting different?
Nah, when you're in the moment, you're not thinking like that. Now, when you watch it later, you might be like, dang, this is crazy.
Yeah.
But at that moment, you're not thinking that. You just
going.
Just trying to do whatever to just make them go as crazy
they
as
was,
you can.
They was going crazy for sure. Oh, like, look at these little kids. Y'all over here running this way.
Oh, they be lit.
They do be lit. So are you going to have, like, some video, not just like a video to the songs, like... shit about your life, you feel me? Like, day in and day out of
EXO,
like, what you do on a daily basis.
Yeah, I actually used to do that, you know, but we actually was talking about that the other day. We actually about to start back doing that, you know, just different little clips of just, you know, life.
Next studio birthday, we'll get that one.
You know, what you say?
The next birthday, we'll get that one.
Nah, y'all gonna get there before that. That's gonna, you know what I'm saying? That's coming soon.
So you think it's gonna be some shit on there that people be surprised at? Like, damn, this is what this boy be doing?
Yeah. Because people don't know how goofy we is. They don't really know. They don't really know who you are. They just they just see you on Instagram.
Right.
Definitely. You know? And then when they see you in person, they be like,
oh,
I thought you was stuck up. Well, I thought you was mean. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. The first time you came here, you did not drink. When did
you?
Alcohol?
Yeah. When did you start back drinking? What you mean, start back? Like, I'm an alcoholic?
No, I'm just saying, because the first time you came, you said you didn't drink. And then I saw
I've
you
never
drinking.
Said that.
Yeah, you definitely.
Going on. You
weren't
drinking around that time.
Yeah.
No,
he was
mean,
here.
It's not that you didn't drink.
Nah, I probably time. Couldn't drink at that time because that probably was the time when I had that DWI.
Oh,
yeah.
Happens to the best of us, huh?
That's the only thing I think of. Because I've never not drink. I don't smoke.
At all?
Yeah, I've never smoked before.
You never wanted to? You never just got the urge to? Why is that? It's just.
I mean, why?
You just don't see it.
Why should I get the urge?
Like, I mean, I'm pretty sure people smoke around you. I'm pretty sure you see it every day. I mean, it just
looked like it's just like somebody smoking. You know, I don't see what the excitement about it is.
I feel you.
Like, it's not a roller coaster or nothing. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I mean, I'm pretty sure you see people fall asleep on it and shit. Like, yeah,
that don't interest me.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Shit.
Like, sleep.
Yeah. What are you doing?
Why is this nigga knocked up?
Yeah, no sleep matters. Y'all don't do that. You know what I'm saying? I can dig it.
That's funny.
So I got a question. I know nowadays music is changing like a motherfucker.
Yeah.
And it's like a lot of like shorter songs. You know what I'm saying? Like the cowboy got the songs like a minute and it's popping. What's the dude that just came out gay?
Old Country Road.
Yeah. No, that's another dude. Cowboy is another dude.
Who? What cowboy?
He got another song. You don't know. I forgot the name of his song.
No,
but it's popping out here. And I know you got songs on your new album. That's like 2 minutes. 2 minutes and 50 seconds. So do you believe like the shortness of a song is what people want to hear now, or do you just did that on purpose? I mean, just did that like naturally.
Well, that record you talking about, I think you talking about Wild 3, and actually 3 minutes, that's really not short.
Yeah.
Them guys' songs be
short.
2 minutes and 15 seconds, stuff like that. You got to think, radio version song, it should be around like 3 minutes and 30 seconds,
right.
Something around there. That's kind of like the perfect time.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, I'm right around 3 minutes. That's a little shorter than normal, but that's not like super short.
Yeah.
These guys is going.
Yeah, it's short and simple.
One verse, and then you look up and the song over.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Do you think that's a new wave? Do you think that?
Yeah, that's just a new wave. That's just a new wave. But it's like, you gotta understand, like, people been doing that since Gold All in My Chain. That was one verse.
It was lengthy, but it was lengthy. He ran it for a little bit.
I'm saying like that stuff been in the works. Hey. People just don't really pay attention to it because music is about feel. So it, you know what I'm saying, it felt good, so people didn't care.
So you think we're going away from the three verses, two hooks type thing? Because you know back in the days, you gotta have three verses.
Yeah, that's too long. Yeah. Nobody's gonna listen to a third verse.
Yeah. So is it like a club area? Because usually music is for you like to be at home and listen to it, but now it's like only solely like for the club. How people gonna react to it in the club? So it's like people only think about the club nowadays.
I think mostly, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that's just the youngsters think like that.
Uh-huh.
It depends on the crowd. Like if you're trying to get the youngsters, then yeah, it's totally different.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're trying to get people that's, you know what I'm saying, a little older.
Mm-hmm.
They want shit they can really jam.
Right.
That facts. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They want to hear some of that shit and be like, man, this is a little motherfucker jam.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
You know?
And keep listening to it and shit like that.
Exactly.
So, can we talk about your first single, Big Bang?
Oh, yeah.
Tell us how that came about. What you going through when you made it up? Like, what's the feeling, what you was doing when you made that up?
Man, it's crazy because when I made that record, the tape was already done.
For real?
Mm-hmm. Yes, the tape was done. I'm talking about mixed and mastered, everything. And one of my homies, you know what I'm saying, he live in L.A., he a producer, shout out to homie D-Will, he ended up sending me a beat.
Mm-hmm.
He was like, hey, bro, I've been trying to send you this beat for a little minute now, bro. You know what I'm saying? I think you should do it, bro. Listen to it. So when I listened to it and I heard it was the Ghetto Boys, I was just like, the remake, I was like, man, this shit hard.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, and then I was thinking, like, man, I got to do this record, especially because of, you know what I'm saying, me signing with Jay and just
Definitely.
Everything. I was like, man, that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I got that recorded and how it came out so hard, I was like, I gotta drop this one. me and my managers in the studio, and I was making it hard, we was just like, damn. Yeah. I'm talking about like 10 minutes in, we sitting there like, boy, I think this is the single. Yeah. And then shit, I just finished that hoe, and that bitch was hard. We was like, hell no. We got that bitch mixed and mastered the same day, nigga. That shit was over.
After you did all your other songs.
I'm talking about the tape was done, bro.
That's crazy.
But that's how Off the Lot was.
Yeah. I guess that shit works sometimes.
And that was the last song I recorded for the tape that I had to drop back then at that time. Mm-hmm. And I just dropped, the song felt like, man, it had to be on there.
That's what's up. Well,
put it on there and then happened.
That's how the magic works. Go ahead and introduce it, man. We're finna go ahead and get into it. Let the world hear it, man.
Check this out, man. We about to get into the new single, Big Bang. You know what I'm saying? It's my new single, Wild 3, all right now. I like the boy.
Yeah, fuck these niggas, this my year, you can't tell me nothing. Got a baby out the west, turn her into something. Why these niggas out here hating, you know how I'm coming. I ain't worried about a thing, all my niggas thugging. Big bang, take love, bang, nigga. I need my money, ain't worried about what you're saying. Big bang, take love, bang, nigga. Bang, switching lines, head up and stay up. Yeah, my chain, hang on my shirt just like a shell. Boy, we was raised in the field, but I had this shell. Lot of shit on my mind, boy, I never tell. Yeah, my mama say stay out of jail. Daddy, he never was here. Yeah, my grandma say, boy, don't you fail. My teacher thought I was a fail. Yeah, my mama say stay out of jail. Daddy, would never was there. Yeah. Grandma say, boy, don't you fail. My teacher thought I was a failure. Yeah. My city slowed down like snails. Yeah. Real nigga gon' blow a hell. Hope my niggas make it out of sale. They be hit like nails. If I got them chests up in the mail, maybe what's that smell? Cause we cooking up this shit about the sale. What the fuck they gon' say to me? Risk cost so cool, ain't it? My ice on my old lady. Yeah. Now I'm friends tryna date, man. Boy, the street get crazy. I ain't worried about none of these pussy niggas. I ain't worried about none of these niggas that be hating. I just need my money, stay up in rotation. Tryna keep my pockets deep, baby, like a basement. Last year took a loss, had my heart racing. You can imagine what a nigga was facing. When it got horrible, a nigga had to shake. Hard work, dedication. Had to protect my reputation. Me, I'm free, boy, just like Mason. Talking handouts, boy, it ain't no. Swinging, bang, switching lines. Head up, stay up. Yeah, my chain, hang on my shirt just like a shell. Boy, we was raised in the field, but I had that shell. Lot of shit up on my mind, boy, I never tell. Yeah, my mama say stay out of jail. My daddy, he never was here. Yeah, my grandma say, boy, don't you fail. Yeah, my teacher thought I was a fail. Yeah, my mama say stay out of jail. My daddy would never was there. My grandma say, boy, don't you fail. Yeah, my teacher thought I was a fail. Yeah. Step my money tall like way up. Make sure my bitch keep a cake up. Make sure she never miss a layup. Smell like a makeup. If it ain't about money, then no one says. Get on my grind, get in lately. Swear this curve, tryna switch my location. Close to the gun, coulda dropped top. Can't stop, baby, I just won't stop. Get my baby heart cold out of ice bomb. Get ice on my teeth, make my jaw lock. Boy, the street get crazy. I ain't worried about none of these pussy niggas. I ain't worried about none of these niggas that be hating. I just need my money, stay up in rotation. Tryna keep my pockets deep, baby, like a basement. Last year took a loss, had my heart racing. You can imagine what a nigga was facing. When it got horrible, a nigga had to shake. Hard work, dedication. Had to protect my reputation. Me, I'm free, boy, just like Mason. Talking handouts, boy, it ain't no. Swinging, bang, switching lines. Head up, stay up. Yeah, my chain, hang on my shirt just like a shell. Boy, we was raised in the field, but I had that shell. Lot of shit up on my mind, boy, I never tell. Yeah, mama say stay out of jail. My daddy, he never was here. My grandma say, boy, don't you fail. My teacher thought I was a fail. My mama say stay out of jail. My daddy would never was there. My grandma say, boy, don't you fail. My teacher thought I was a fail.
got XO in the building.
Sure.
So what was that we just heard right there, the second song?
Oh yeah, that's Never Feel, man. That's out right now too, so y'all can go stream that, the video out, go check it out.
I was digging that. I like that song, like, man.
It. It's a vibe.
It's definitely a vibe, yeah. I know you talk about kind of like your childhood in both of them songs. You talk about the West of Lights, the Shadows of the Swat, and you talk about like your mama and your parents and stuff like that. Yeah. You try to be like personal in all your music like that?
Well, this new tape, that's really why I like this new tape a lot, because it's personal. I open up kind of, you know, my life a little bit on definitely. This one. I get a little more personal than just making songs, you know?
Yeah, definitely.
Was it easier for you to do that?
Yeah, because I come from that, so... You know what I'm saying? It's a little easier. That's easier for me than making all that other stuff.
Right.
Like, Off the Lot is harder than me making a song about going through stuff.
Right.
So your brain is harder for you to think about what to say? Are you trying to, like, please the people when you do, like, a song like Off the Lot? Or are you just, why is it harder for you?
I mean, I'm saying, like, it's not hard.
Yeah.
It's not hard for me to do that. I'm just saying those records, they come out easy. It's easier for me because I have a lot, you know what I'm saying? I have a lot that I've never even talked about.
Definitely.
You know what I'm saying? Nobody's ever heard that side of me.
Definitely.
You know what I'm saying? I've never talked about none of that. So now that's really just all sitting in my head. And we didn't all talked about partying and money and all that stuff all day.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, definitely. And I also want to ask you, how do you feel about the SWAT? Because y'all popping right now. Y'all got a lot going on right now. All across
we
the world.
Thing. We in everything. Yeah, boxing, definitely. Music, producing.
All that.
All that.
It's crazy, yeah. Y'all everywhere.
We out you.
Shout out to the SWAT, man. Y'all really doing it. I guess that's the SWAT. That's the how y'all doing, huh?
I don't know what's going on. I look up and we just
everywhere.
Getting it in.
I was noticing, I was like, man, you got Maxo, you got Charlo Twins, you got Deja, you got you, you know what I'm saying? You got Beezy.
Toby,
like a motherfucker. Like y'all just everywhere. It's crazy. Did you know any of these cats before music?
Yeah. So, yes. Only person I didn't know is I didn't know Toby.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Toby kind of, you know, like when we was coming up, Toby kind of, he was doing his thing, but he wasn't jumping yet. He was just still doing a little videos and different stuff like that.
Yeah.
And I remember he came up to me a lot of different times just saying like that, you know, I inspire him and stuff like that, just coming from our side.
That's crazy.
But, you know what I'm saying, he just kept going and looked up and he was right there with us. You know what I'm saying? Now he doing his thing. Commercials, all type of shit.
Yeah, he big time now.
You know what I'm saying? So, tours, he just did like his own tour.
He did. He definitely did. And he was selling out shows everywhere.
For real.
Yeah, that's crazy. So would you ever do like a song with him?
Of course, yeah.
Do you think it'd be difficult for you to do a song with him?
Nope. I can do a song with anybody, bro. As long as it's not like Egyptian or something.
I was about to say, anybody.
As long as it ain't like, you know, like an Indian record or something.
Yeah. You can get out with a African record?
Yeah.
Like has it come to play it?
Nobody you gotta think. Like nah, nobody's ever hit me, but you gotta think. Like, listen to DeVito, Autumn Cats. Like, we can, you know what I'm saying? We can get on the records. Like, think about, like, an artist like Drake.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, we can do that type of stuff. Mm-hmm. It's easy. Now, my accent might not be
the same.
Yeah, but I'm going to sound like me. Right. I'm going to sound like, you know what I'm saying?
So are you going to really try to have an accent when you do those type of music?
Nah, I'm going
to
sound like me. It's the same as if they get on when I record.
Yeah, facts, right?
You know what I'm saying? When I record, they got like an up-tempo vibe, you feel. They going to sound like them. You know what I'm saying?
Most definitely.
That's funny.
It is funny.
Did you eat breakfast today?
Not yet.
This
is my breakfast right here.
It happens. Mm-hmm. The goddamn wake up. What you going to eat after this?
I don't know yet. I'm not sure.
I want some pancakes.
Girl, that was random.
I want some pancakes. I'm sorry. I was thinking about it like, I'm pretty fucking hungry.
Right. So, go ahead. Because you're talking about food and shit.
I had some for the food, you feel me, still. Because, like I said, you feel me, I saw you jumping around on stage, all that good shit. Like, you have to make sure you're healthy enough to do that shit, not pass the fuck out. So, like, how do you keep yourself healthy? Like, are you vegan? What are you doing right now?
I mean, I wouldn't say that you... I'm going to tell you this. I wouldn't say that people... They jump around stage and got energy are all healthy because they're not.
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to tell you that right now.
That's true.
But it's just like anything. You know what I'm saying? After you do it so much, you just build stamina. You know what I'm saying? So, like, that's really all it is. And then you learn how to cheat. Like, you learn how to take your breaks in between certain parts to be able to get through it. So, it's just, it's all strategy. You know what I'm saying? But, I mean, I do, like, eat a lot better now. But, you know what I'm saying? All them videos you seen, I wasn't eating good then. I was just doing whatever I wanted.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We was drunk, everything. That might have helped. I don't know.
Maybe so.
For sure.
Maybe. You know, they usually do.
So how do you strategize, like how to put in work? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, do you have, like, I mean,
you can't strategize it, bro. That got to be in you, bro.
Facts, right? But I'm talking about, like, for you being a DJ, you have, okay, I'm going to be a DJ at this time. I'm going to be I'm going to write at this time. I'm going to produce at this time. I'm going to practice for the show at this time. Or you just do it however it comes.
Nah, I just be what I need to be when it's time to be it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I just be a comedian. If I need a DJ, then I'm a DJ. If I need to go out there and, you know what I'm saying, be the artist, I'm going to go be the artist.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? You just got to be one of them people that can turn it on when it's time to turn it on.
So you're the type to, like, just be seeing something or hear something or feel something, like, okay, let me write this down in my notes so I can save it and I can write on it later?
Well, like, you talking like when I'm creating music?
Yeah, when you create music. When you write, when you finna write it, man.
Well, see, I don't write.
At all?
No. I don't write. I'm more so, I got to explain it to you. Like, basically what I'll do is, like, I'll load up a track.
Uh-huh.
Now we in the studio.
Hey.
We got the track laid. I go in the booth.
Uh-huh.
What I do is I create what I call is, like, my vibe track.
Right? Okay.
What I'll do is I'll kind of freestyle through the whole song with just, like, my melodies. I might not have no words, but it'll just be, like, the melodies of what I feel, like, all the way through. Then once I got that laid, how I like it, like, the feel, then I'll come back bar for bar and replace the melodies, like what I was doing, were like words.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You like come up with all that right there, all the words right there.
Yeah. And I do it like that. You know what I'm saying? Most of the reason why I do it like that is because, like, you can't. It's certain feelings and certain things that people do. You can't write that down.
Facts.
Like when you hear some of them crazy notes from people, and you hear all this.
Yeah.
Like that, you can't write that down. Like right here, I'm gonna be like, oh, you know what I'm saying? You gotta actually go in there and do that.
Yeah,
you feel me? So it's like, that's why I create that way.
Yeah, it's crazy. So you do all your songs like that.
Mm-hmm.
That's crazy.
So I did Off the Lot like that.
Yeah.
You know, that was 3.5 years ago.
Uh-huh. So you actually spend a lot of time in the studio then?
Nah, it don't really take that long like that.
It's crazy.
It don't really take that long like that, bro. And then you got nothing, you got to think. Once you get to the point where you get good at this,
mm-hmm.
you know what I'm saying? Yeah. That stuff really flow. It really flow easier than you think.
So how long does it take you to make an album then?
I don't know. I mean, how long you think that it would take me? Or because if I'm just create, like, if I'm like, okay, hey, so how fast you can make an album? How fast can y'all turn in an album? You know what I'm saying? I mean, I could do a whole album in a week. I could do a whole album in 5 days if I needed to.
Yeah.
And they're going to be jamming.
So do you
know what I'm saying? Now, they might not all be, like, mixed and mastered and stuff like that in time, but I can have 12 songs that jam ready to put out, like, that's, you know what I'm saying?
So it's really nothing to you. It's like a piece of cake.
Yeah, bro.
That's crazy.
So in high school, what type of guy were you in high school? Was you the one that's being on the tables, always freestyling, you was always messing with
in people? In middle school, I used to beat on the tables. Mm-hmm. I was number the freestyle. I was the one that did the beats, in middle school.
Mm-hmm. And in high school,
we was just the cool, we was just, hey.
Cool kids.
We just was the guys. We played sports, we did everything.
Yeah, whatever y'all did was popping, huh?
We just did
You still
everything.
Was a vibe created back in the day, huh? It's nothing new.
Yeah, right? it just wasn't making songs.
That makes sense.
We was definitely the innovators. And the penetrators.
Hey. I mean, he did something a little different. He was like, the nigga was like the best dancer in the school.
Oh, yeah, oh, well, okay. Yeah, I was like the best dancer.
You used
like,
to be dancing?
Used to
dancing.
Like
yeah, I used
best.
To dance.
Like, what was your favorite
like,
dance?
Like, I was like
the Austin used to dance and all that?
Like
yeah, but he's
that.
Not even close.
Oh, my God.
I was
what
coach.
Was your favorite dance?
Like there wasn't no.
I
want to
see it.
It's like the music.
What? Like
nah.
It was Chris Brown type.
Nah,
yeah.
No, like no.
But listen, just no similar to that.
Yeah.
But see, We was the guys that, like, when we see Kareem on dance, we be like, this nigga sucks.
He trash.
Nah, we was really good. We was next level. We was like battle. We was like competition. Hey,
we need the visuals. Oh, we need some visuals.
Y'all gotta understand. People like Chris Brown, you gotta understand. Like, when you a real dancer, you know what I'm saying? It's a different level of dancing than it is.
Right.
Like, it's not saying that Chris Brown is not good, because he is. But he was more like choreography style.
Yeah,
he's doing like bust a flip. And then, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And that's like, that ain't gonna cut it when you dancing against a real nigga that really dances in the streets. Like, it's the same as like basketball players. Like, you know what I'm saying? The greatest basketball player, he's not in the NBA.
He probably never made it.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
He's somebody out here, nigga, and everybody that know him or that in that area just be like, boy, I wish this nigga would've made it.
Like, what the fuck?
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, that's kind of how that
works.
I can see this nigga ticking in my head, though. Back in the day,
oh, God, I'm trying to see a dance move.
I mean, I guarantee you would have to be in a moment back then.
You're
not
going
to be able to imagine.
Nah, it ain't
going to. Just know I was the GOAT.
I know when you asked that high school question, you were looking for an answer that kind of corresponds with your music.
Yeah.
That's when I first met him, that's one of the things I can say that corresponded with how he is now. Like the GOAT. Yeah. Like that nigga.
That's crazy.
The
keep saying
answer.
The GOAT. That shit crazy.
I'm talking about nigga. I was like, breaking nigga.
That shit crazy.
You know what I'm saying?
Wait.
No cap.
I'm talking about. I will break a nigga bitch ass off.
Before we get into more music, what made you stop dancing? Like, okay, I'm not doing it. I'm doing everything else with entertainment.
No, I mean, you just, over time, you just grow into, you know, other things.
I mean, but it's still entertainment. You just chose just not to do that.
I mean, I still can dance. I just, you know, it's just not a time to just bust out of dancing in the middle of a... You know what I'm saying?
Like, really the world, dancing is, hey, it's still, it's different types.
Trendy. It's like trendy.
Yeah, but see, that's different. See, you're not getting what I'm saying.
See,
he thinking like, Dougie and stuff like that.
I'm thinking about everything.
Nah, I'm talking about like a real dancer, bro. Like, they can do everything.
Like the twin, like the twins that was dancing with Beyonce.
The last twins.
The last twins.
Yeah, like they're good dancers. They're good dancers. Like Chris Brown wouldn't be able to.
He
wouldn't be able to fuck, but that's what I'm saying. That's what, like, he wouldn't be able to fuck with them.
Hey.
And either one of them, a smash Chris Brown.
Thanks. And you're on their level.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. On that
listen,
note.
Listen, I was listening.
Y'all laughing. We ain't laughing.
No, hear me out.
I can dig it.
In high school, listen to me. In high school, I was like that.
Yeah.
I'm telling you.
I got a partner that used to get down like that. I got a partner, he was a beast.
Listen.
They stand in circles. I'm talking about he'll smash anybody.
In high school, I was like that, bro.
Yeah.
I'm telling you. I was nothing to play with, bro.
Man.
For real. I'm talking about competition. Like, nigga, that's how I helped my mama make money, nigga, to feed us, my nigga.
Damn.
We need some of that on them vlogs when they come back out. We need
definitely.
Some
of
that.
That's gonna cost you now.
I'm gonna antagonize the shit.
Cause that ain't you know that's gonna cost you. Cause that ain't what we promoting right now.
I feel
you gotta understand. You gotta understand. That's why, you know what I'm saying. At the end of the day, you know what I'm saying. Like, I'm one of them type of guys where, you know what I'm saying, I'm gonna always be able to hit people from a different angle every time.
Right.
Like, it's gonna be a moment in my career where I get high enough, and then I'm gonna hit them. The dancing, that type of stuff gonna come out because I'm probably gonna be at an award show and they're gonna be like, XO, we're gonna have background dancers on this. We like a little dance. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They're gonna fuck around, see the moves.
Yeah.
And next thing you know, I'm doing a full nigga. And now I shot
the
world. Now I was right here and it made me go right here because, you see what I'm saying? It was the shock factor.
Yeah.
So it's like, you gotta learn how to use everything you good at, bro, at certain parts. You don't come out and just give them everything. You feel me? Like, people don't know I do that unless you grew up with me or grew up like in the Southwest. Like, I went to Elsick High School, Olive Middle School, all over there. So unless you came up over there,
You don't know nothing about
you don't even know that I even got that in my package. You feel me?
Definitely. Hey, free game from XO, man. I hope y'all was listening, man. You can't give it all away.
Man.
You hear me? But we got some more songs, you know what I'm saying? We got some more songs to play. Which one do people hear next, man?
Y'all got everything?
We got what you're saying over there? That's just...
Okay, well, let's get into that.
Well, goddamn.
This is a DJ
that's prepared.
Let's get it.
Let's get it.
I keep a motherfucking check, yeah. Look at my chain, my necklace. Sipping that drink in Texas. Baby, give me brain like Hess, yeah. Gon' eat it up like Tex-Mex. Tell my bitch, let's have rich sex. Louis V shoes got six pair. Ice my bitch out like Ric Flair. Whoa, all of my niggas some shot. Thugs, fuck around, boy, need a doctor. We ain't just looking for smoke. But boy, don't you come with that drama. When you just coming from nada, you only worry about karma. Ain't how to take care of your mama. I'm trying to see what you saying. See what you saying. What if I say? 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 What if I say?
I flip the bag, gotta use the cash out, make a somersault type shit. I go to sleep without my chains on, feel like the lights on in it, bitch.
I'm about to boss up type shit. I break you off all type shit. I get the bag, put my mama in a brand new house shit. I flip the bag, gotta use the cash out, make a somersault type shit. I go to sleep without my chains on, feel like the lights on in it, bitch. I'm about to boss up type shit. I break you off all type shit. I get the bag, put my mama in a brand new house shit. I flip the bag, gotta use the cash out, make a somersault type shit. I go to sleep without my chains on, feel like the lights on in it, bitch. I'm on some fuck you haters type shit. I'm on some trendsetting type shit. I got a pocket full of money, but I still wait till the third to pay my rent. I ain't gotta lie, I ain't gotta try, I ain't gotta whine. We just get money, you ain't gotta dime. We just ball on them, call me Kobe Bryant. I'm on some top down type shit. Respect the H-Town type shit. I used to ride the bus, catch the 483-23 type shit. I'm on some diamond dance type shit. 50k ice tray my shit. 0-4-10 chains, little flip type shit. I got a partner's hitting licks type shit. Couple partners whipping bricks, type shit. Never shit, team type shit, type shit. They don't want no smoke, type shit. I'm about to boss up, type shit. I break you off, all type shit. I get the bag, put my mama in a brand new house shit. I flip the bag, gotta use the cash out, make a somersault type shit. I go to sleep without my chains on, feel like the lights on in it, bitch. I'm about to boss up, type shit. I break you off, all type shit. I get the bag, put my mama in a brand new house shit. I flip the bag, gotta use the cash out, make a somersault type shit. I go to sleep without my chains on, feel like the lights on in it, bitch.
I'm on some multi type shit. Nigga, we gon' all ride type shit. You know, I got some hustle niggas in my roster. Yeah. Nigga love to play with them bricks. Yeah. I got duct tape in it, bitch. But what a duck say in it, bitch. I got a sky dweller, cost a whole buck. That's 100k, no tick. True story. Got 10k, that's a light day. That pocket chain, little nick, little nick. Got exclusive gang, nigga, 4-way. Told him upgrade my drip. You know, I'm on some late show type shit. Hey, I'm an ITO type nigga. You know, hey, my street credit over 800. Nigga, fight cocaine, skelly. Boss. I'm the type to trap and buy the house type nigga. Yeah. I'm the type to trap out that whole house type nigga. I'm an 802 type nigga. Grief. One godfather, nothing bigger. Yeah. I don't need a cosign. Street know I'm really about that type nigga. Boss.
I'm about to boss up type shit. Whoa. I break you off all type shit. Whoa. I get the bag. Put my mama in a brand new house shit. Yeah. I get the bag. Gotta use the cash out. Make a somersault type shit. I go to sleep without my chains on. Feel like the lights on in it, bitch. I'm about to boss up type shit. I break you off all type shit. I get the bag. Put my mama in a brand new house shit. I flip the bag. Gotta use the cash out. Make a somersault type shit. I go to sleep without my chains on. Feel like the lights on in it, bitch.
Oh Lord, oh my God, I'm fucking fired. I'm fucking fired because I damn near, I just missed it all. It happens to the best of us.
What's on your mind?
Sober.
Right?
Yes, and I'm fucking hungry. I need some fucking pancakes, bro.
So what you got for the future, man? What you got in store for the future? What can the people expect this for the rest of this year, these last 6 months?
They can expect the Money Round Here remix coming.
Oh, okay.
Soon. Can't tell y'all who on, so don't ask.
I was gonna say.
How long
does it take? I was gonna let you hear that.
Just know it's a big
remix,
name.
Remix, huh?
Okay. Can we get where they from, the regions? Can we get anything?
Nope.
Oh my God.
Nah, because you gonna start calling our names. Hey. Nope. Just know that's coming soon, so y'all can look out for that.
Mm-hmm.
And, I should be leaving for tour soon too. We just trying to finish some stuff up, you know. So y'all can definitely be expecting that.
What's something that's gonna be on your writer?
A fish and shrimp plate.
Mm.
a whole bunch of money.
Yeah, yeah.
And, needed. Some Hennessy for sure.
Okay.
Some Hennessy, some champagne, fish and shrimp plate.
What if they don't cook? I need a massage.
Oh, yeah,
okay.
Don't be bouncing back like that. I gotta make sure my shit together so when I get on stage, I can give y'all the best performance.
Definitely.
Those are just a few things that they in my life.
Just a little razzle dazzle.
Goddamn. I know it's gonna be some more on there.
Nah, it's some more shit on there now.
For sure.
I just ain't got time to run the whole thing by y'all, you know what I'm saying?
I get it. I ain't gonna lie, I get it. I can dig it, fam. But we finna go ahead and get up out of here so you can tell the world again where they can find you at, what you got out right now, and everything. Just pub yourself.
YL3 is out right now. The new single's out, Big Bang. Make sure y'all go get that, stream that, do all that. Buy that, support it.
Yes.
Facts.
Also,
that shit.
If y'all need to get in touch with me or just want to show me some love, my Instagram at XONoSleep. Get at your boy.
All right, that's what it is, man. DJ XO. It was great having you, man. Great talking to you. Hope we can see you again.
Oh,
best
yeah.
of luck to you in the future, man. It's going down. It's a Wake Up Morning Show. DJ Maya Papaya. Let's get another mix in. What it do? This is Wake Up Morning Show. I am Filthy Dre.
What up, that's your girl, No Bra Breezy.
It's your girl, DJ Mike.
Hi. And we got my mans in a bit of man. Tell me who you are.
Man, y'all know the face on the name, DJ XO, man. Make sure y'all go get YO3 out now. Make sure y'all go get Big Bang out now.
That's what it is, man. It's the Wake Up Morning Show. We live Monday through Friday, 9:30 to 11:30 a.m. It's going down. Check it out. And shout out to our sponsor, Urban Bubba Bar. Get out the way, you.
No, they can't, no, no. We had on the same clothes, yeah.